The old saying is that time flies, and that has certainly been the case with the Tiger Pregame Show. In the 20 years of the show, we have seen just about everything. Great wins, heartbreaking losses, incredible trips to locations in 13 different states, some of which I never imagined I would see while traveling with the Tigers. So in this 20th season, I thought I would chronicle the year, the travels, and the thoughts to document this anniversary season. I hope you will join me in this journey on the Tiger Pregame Show's 20th season blog. Here we go. It's Rivalry Day in Clemson, South Carolina, Death Valley behind me. The Tigers and the Gamecocks. It's always a lot of fun. Added to that, it's a noon game, which will make for a challenge getting everybody over here, but also for the pregame show. It's almost 5:30 right now, and I've arrived here at the Swann Pavilion. And the other thing is, this should a lot of extra excitement. The Gamecocks, crazy win last week against Tennessee. Number 5 Tennessee, and scored a bunch of points in doing it. So, should be a great atmosphere. I'm going to pan around here for a second, and you can see behind me, that's Doug Kingsmore Stadium, lit up, looking nice behind me, and I'm going to get ready to get the final touches set up, and then we'll get some video from up top of the Swann Pavilion. Qualk is, hope you're enjoying yourself in wherever you are. It's a some place with a lot of sun and beach, and we have a one chair stage today for you. One chair, since you'll be. All right, everything's set up. We're now ready for the 266th edition of the Tiger Pregame Show Rivalry Week, Clemson and South Carolina. And for the final time in 2022, we're here at the Swann Pavilion. You can see beautiful Memorial Stadium in Death Valley behind me. And then, of course, the lawn at Little John is all back there. Nobody really set up yet, but they will be soon. And then, of course, behind us here, the stage area. Great location to do the pregame show, and always appreciate being here. It's exciting when we start the season. It's a little sad when we end it, but hopefully next year, 21st year, we'll see what happens with the Tiger pregame show. You just never know. But if so, I hope we'll be right back here. Don't be nothing but a good.
Don't be better, baby.
We've got some Clemson students who have made their way over to the Swann Pavilion. And I particularly wanted to hear from this group, and I'll let them introduce themselves, because they have had a very unique Clemson experience. So let's start, ladies, by introducing yourself and what your major is.
Hello, my name is Winnie Zing. I'm from Greenville, South Carolina, and my major is industrial engineering.
Hi, my name is Anna, and I'm majoring in supply chain and finance.
Hi, my name is Megan Reimer, and I'm majoring in parks, recreation, and tourism management.
So you may have caught that last little part, William Quackenbush, and maybe the reason why the three are over here. But I did mention that it's a very unique experience. You are 4-year students. You went home in your first year. COVID came, and in March after spring, you went to spring break, all excited about spring break, then you went home for the rest of the year. Then you had the wonky year after that. But what I think is the most interesting about your time here at Clemson, other than the fact you've overcome so much, this is the first time South Carolina has played here during your time.
Yes, so it's a little tragic that this is our last and final game, but I think it's a little extra special that we at least get to experience this rivalry between us and South Carolina. It's a little tragic because that sophomore year we didn't get to do as much as we wanted to, but it makes those extra little moments extra special. So I'm excited. Go Tigers.
Yeah, I would have to agree. I think it was a little disappointing not being able to experience before now, but I think it creates a lot of good hype for today, and it's a good way to end out our senior year of football.
Yeah, I feel the same way. Last one, best one, I guess. Get to experience it all together for the first time, which is exciting.
Now, I know the students have been on fall break, so hopefully, or not fall, Thanksgiving break, I should say. Hopefully, they all are coming back. What's the vibe? Students, you think you're going to have a great student crowd here today?
I definitely think the crowd will be wild. I know a lot of friends that don't go to Clemson also will be here, so it's exciting to see how many people do show up for the opposing side as well, but it's exciting.
All right, you get one Clemson-South Carolina game. That's it, unless you go to grad school. So this is it. Give us a prediction of what you're going to see today. Give me a score.
I'm thinking 31-28, somewhere around
here. Oh, close. And I'm assuming Clemson is your pick on that?
Yes.
Okay, 31-28 and a close one, aren't you?
I'm going to say 21-3, Clemson.
Oh, okay, so not as close. Dominating defensive performance. And Megan?
I'm going to go 28-14.
28-14, a little bit of a nail biter, but a win nonetheless. All right, well, thank you all for getting up so early in the morning to come by the Tiger pregame show, and we need that student section to arrive early, get on the hill, fill the hill up, and all that good stuff, and be very, very loud, of course. And there you go, William Quackenbush.
All right, number 266 is in the books. It's time to go tailgate a little bit and get ready for this game. Tigers and the Gamecocks. Rivalry week returns to Memorial Stadium in Death Valley. Another great year here. It's hard to complain. The job I have of broadcasting Clemson from Death Valley, Memorial Stadium, Swann Pavilion, all those things overlooking Death Valley. But it's an honor to do it. It's a lot of work sometimes, but the payout's pretty good. Of course, doing what I love. It's Clemson, Clemson football, Clemson University. What's not to love about it? So for the final time in 2022, we say goodbye to the Swann Pavilion, and it's time to tailgate. Get ready, the Tigers and the Gamecocks.
I can tell you what this is. This is 7.
We were the last loss to
you were closer to the thing.
Heck of a tailgate here. All this stuff, good Lord. We're never gonna eat all this food. It's not even to mention sides and of course breakfast. You don't go hungry at the Reimer tailgate. The Reimer tailgate.
You know what's funny is I bet Ice would wear a long time. Wasn't what we wanted. Disappointing day in Clemson. The morning after rain here kind of sums up the mood as the Gamecocks absolutely took it to us. And there's no other way to say it other than that. Congratulations to them. It's a disappointing loss. We've got to try to figure out how to muster up enough energy and will and all of those things to try to win an ACC championship next Saturday, which is a big deal. But no college football playoffs for us this year. Second straight year that will not be the case. So disappointing. It happens. You know, I'm 50 years old. It has happened before. You know, if I live another 50, it's going to happen again in the future. So it's never a good feeling. And the rain you hear behind me pretty much sums up the mood on a Sunday morning after losing to the Gamecocks. Until next week.